Live from Los Angeles, welcome to Good Morning La La Land. I'm Dr. Aaron.
Hi, I'm Rob Mack.
And I'm Jessica Moyer. This is Good Morning La La Land, America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch. Also available on Apple TV and Roku via the EverTalk app.
That's right, it's hashtag Wealth Wednesday. We're going to talk about how to have some tips to have a powerful talk, because so many people want to be public speakers, even though they're afraid of it. We come together every day to know the truth, live on spiritual principle, align with universal law, and have 1,000 guests.
Yes.
Amazing guests today, right?
It's good to be in demand.
It is.
Absolutely.
It is.
On hashtag Wealth Wednesday, we're so excited to celebrate our community and the premiere of the new film, Bennett's War. Good morning, everyone back in the studio. Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Just a sneak peek at just a couple of our guests this morning. We've got Anya in the house. And who is your little puppy with you?
That's Freya.
Aww. I love some puppy love.
Super cute. Look at those ears.
We're talking Happy Again Pet, one of the new collagen supplements for dogs. But first, Anya, we'd like to know, how do you start your day?
I walk my dog first thing. Wow. And then work out.
Boom.
Groundbreaking.
Yes. Simple. Perfect.
Oh, absolutely. We're excited to welcome Michael Rohr to the show. I'm so happy our paths have crossed. Once again, we met maybe a decade ago in Hollywood?
Yeah, I think it was, do I need this mic? I think it was about a decade. Yeah, it's been a while.
Oh, it's so incredible. I was so happy when his name slid across my inbox. Congratulations on the premiere of Bennett's War.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. So how does an actor like you start his day in Hollywood? What's your morning routine?
Oh, I'm a big believer in morning routine. First thing out of bed, I have like a whole, I like to do a quick workout. Meditate, write. It's like a whole 40, 50 minute process. So I think it's really important to start the day.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. I wish I could get those blue eyes like that. That's incredible, right? That the morning routine leads to those blue eyes. There you go.
He was just born that way. Allison Page is with us. Congratulations on the premiere of Bennett's War, Allison.
Thank you.
So tell us, how do you start your day? What's your morning routine?
Oh man, I wake up and my dogs smother me with kisses. That's how I start my morning, every morning.
Sounds much better than mine.
Yeah. I'm not quite as routine, but yeah, dog kisses. That's how I start my day.
Well, thank you so much for being with us. We're excited to continue the conversation later in the show.
Oh, yeah, thank you for having us.
Awesome. Right? How was Girl Church last night?
Oh my gosh, you guys. So it was the last Girl Church of the summer. It was actually I think it was my favorite Girl Church ever. I don't know why, if it was just because it was the last one of the season or whatever, but I think also we've just kind of, you know, the whole thing is kind of, we've gotten used to getting a true transformational event together. So last night was, the content was on point and whatever. And I just want to say thank you to Kimpton Lapierre, who's made it all possible. And the girl, you guys, the women, and we did have a few token men come up, but the women that show up are so powerful, huge influencers, like people with 100,000, 300,000 followers, like the amount of what is drawn in there is these powerful women. It's pretty interesting to watch.
I'm not surprised, Erin. Yes. It's a testament to you and your power. I mean, I think, you know, one of the things I love about you is so much is the way in which you do connect with people. And I think, you know, the people that showed up obviously show up for you and they show up for the message.
Right. I'm really not, you guys know that. I don't schmooze with everybody. I'm like, whatever I get.
Yeah, you're but strategic about it though.
Well,
intentional.
It's more like it just like it vibes or you don't vibe. Yeah. Like I'm not going to like pretend and kiss people's asses just because like, how about you guys? How was your night?
Yeah. It was fantastic. How was yours, Jess?
I was at Girl Church in spirit. Mm-hmm. I was on the red carpet celebrating the premiere of 47 Meters Down, the sequel Uncaged. We have a look at last night's event. Let's take a peek. Primed to be one of this summer's biggest blockbusters, we are coming to you from the red carpet premiere of 47 Meters Down, Uncaged. Stay tuned for some really fun interviews and, of course, hashtag Sharkbait.
Hi, my name is Brianna Chu, and you're watching Good Morning La La Land.
Hey, I'm Brooke Bassinger, and you're watching Good Morning La La Land.
Sharkbait.
47 meters down. Are you a natural born adventurer?
I think I am. Yeah. I mean, my family's always been like quite the outdoors people. And yeah, I love thrill. Yeah, for sure.
But when you read the script, was any part of you scared or nervous?
I mean, yeah, I had seen the first one, so I knew a little bit what to expect, but even after doing it, when I saw the final results, I'm not gonna lie, I jumped a couple times just because I hadn't seen, we were not acting with like those real sharks. It was like fake plastic sharks. So when I saw the final version, I freaked out. They were so big, they looked so mean.
Well, you look like absolute shark bait tonight. Tell us about your cameo in this film.
I got to play the mean girl, so you know it was very easy to get there for me. Totally kidding. It was really cool. The mean girls were so much fun to work with. I got to be in the Dominican Republic for like way too long for the amount like I'm in the film, but I just like took advantage of it, saw the culture, and it was great.
Top three shark movies of all time.
Jaws, the first Jaws of all time. 47 meters down, and then 47 meters down on Cage. Those are the top three.
For the thrill of your life, go check out 47 meters down on Cage. Swipe up.
Great job, Jess.
Awesome, thanks. Jess.
It was so much fun. Special thanks to Byron Allen, Entertainment Studios, and of course our dear friend Eric Peterowski for including us at last night's event. Stars of the past, present, and future were out in droves. Frank Stallone was there, and Sylvester Stallone, of course, because his daughter Sistine was in the film, also Jamie Foxx. His daughter was making her feature film debut. It was a star-studded event.
Amazing. You did the red carpet. I did the white comforter. It wasn't nearly as fashionable, but it was definitely as comfortable.
We all were in our genius last night. Yeah. So speaking of Wealth Wednesday, you know, so many people want to be public speakers. It's one of the things people are most afraid of. And last night, you know, if I do so myself, I was on point last
night. There you go.
There's days where you know you're in the zone and days where you know you're not as much in the zone. And I was thinking about, because people are like, "What? You know, you're such a good speaker. How do you do that?" And I have to say that I used to be so nervous, and I used to, quite frankly, suck. But there are, like, four tips I have for getting your public speaking on. So number one, for me anyway, is to be tapped into source. You got to be grounded in the earth and into the universe to get inspired, because otherwise, if you're not inspired by source, then I don't think you're going to be inspired on stage.
Totally. That's what it is. Inspiration in spirit.
Right?
So I love that. So what do you do to get inspired and to get tapped into source, Erin?
I mean, I have to do an invocation, so I always begin the night with an invocation, so I make sure that I'm really tapped in right there, sure.
What's an invocation?
It's like a prayer, but it's not just a man in the sky. It's knowing the truth, expanding consciousness, and being one with all everything, right?
Yep.
So number two is having what I call a virtual share. So always story, we learn for story, but instead of saying like, one day, you know, 1999, I was, you know, whatever, you have to take them there. So there I was. It was 1999. I was standing on the corner of the street, and this is what happened. So you have to take people into the actual. It's like that's why we like movies, right? Because we want a virtual share. Number three is it needs to be transformational. People want an experience. So if you just preach to them, it's not going to be very much fun. So having a transformation to it.
So what do you do about that? How do you make it experiential? How do you make it something that's interesting and interactive?
For me, I believe it's a distinction that has people think, that has them shift their perspective or whatever that is. I think a great TED Talk, anything, it's something you never, it's a new concept. That's what has to be transformational.
I love that. And if you don't have that, you can always offer rosé or drinks.
Yeah, that's true, right?
Become a lot more,
that's
a lot more
right.
interactive.
And then number four is to have a takeaway. People want to be led. They want to have an actionable thing they can take it and change and transform their life.
Yeah, so is that sort of like tips and tricks to apply what you said or shared in the talk to their daily lives?
Whatever that is. Maybe it's, you know, to sign up for SoulCiety. No, just kidding. Whatever that is. A great TED Talk will tell people to, you know, take it back into their life at whatever level, how they apply it to their life.
I love that. Uh-huh. Thanks for coming. Venmo me. Send me some PayPal. Here's check.
Action. Right. You know, you're such an avid reader, but are there any talks that you've seen recently that really spoke to you?
Great question. I listen to a lot of, like, the top 10 rules for success. It's just really spliced together different interview clips of like really sort of successful people in different industries and fields. I think Amy Cuddy's talk is still one of the most popular talks. You know, I'm a big fan of like talks that are sort of extemporaneously given. So they're just kind of from the heart and they're not scripted and they're not planned. Mm-hmm. And so my favorite sort of speakers are always like spiritual teachers. So, you know,
they're just so good. It seems like they're
not
scripted.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Uh-huh. It's coming from a deeper place on the inside. And so, you know, I think there's so many people that I love, but I would say that certainly Oprah gives a great talk.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Sure.
So does your sister.
So does my sister. She's great about that.
She's great about that.
It's interesting because I think some of the greatest speakers are preachers often. Yeah. Even though, you know, we sort of live in a different day and age, preachers are fantastic. Yeah. I mean, the way they feel so purpose-driven around their message. They're so passionate. Mm-hmm. That emotion is contagious.
I just sing that John Legend song, Preach, and that does it for me.
That's right. Music, for sure, is the greatest speech ever. Anyway, let's take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk to our guests about how they've created lives that they love and true wealth. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Where can you watch the stories of people changing the world? EverTalk TV, the Netflix of talk. I'm Jez Moyer, the co-founder and host of EverTalk TV, and I am thrilled to introduce you to America's first live video streaming talk show network.
I'm so excited to be here on the couch with all you amazing people. Yeah. I'm just in complete awe. Thank you.
Happy to be here. And for those who don't know what goes on, this is a big old place. There's a lot going on here.
You do this every day.
Why?
God bless you guys. I mean, people, there's a lot going on.
Thank you for having me. This is an awesome studio.
Thank you for having me. I'm so excited.
I feel that.
How exciting, Motivation Monday. And the guests this morning have been incredible.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here with you.
We have Rachel Bosson, who is in The Last Bridesmaid on Hallmark. It actually is dropping tomorrow, the 22nd, right?
It is. Tomorrow night's our premiere.
Woo! Wow.
Congratulations. I am so excited to welcome Jason and Ashley Waller to the show. Congratulations on the new beginnings. We're so excited for the premiere on MTV tonight.
Congratulations. Thank you, guys. We appreciate it. Thank you.
The book is actually being shipped out today. It published this week.
Congratulations.
You guys are the first show that I've actually done on talking about the book.
I think this is my first time my book's been up on TV. This is
awesome. Our friends at Universal Pictures have a special delivery for us this morning from a Tethered himself.
Ooh.
Have you seen the film Us by Emmy Award winner Jordan Peele?
You know, I'm sitting here next to you guys and it's just like, this is a powerful moment for me. Like, you know, I'm humbled by it because it's like, I'm sharing this movie with you guys and it's moving for me.
What are you most grateful for today?
I am so grateful to be here and to have the opportunity to be with all these wonderful, badass boss babes and with all of you. And it's just a wonderful opportunity to share the positive messages out in the world because I think the world really needs it right now.
What we've done and thanking me for the contribution we're making to their lives.
Oh, nice. That's great.
This is what my purpose is. This is why I was born.
Now, show the camera.
Up to you to choose the winner. Is it Annie? Is it Haley?
That's why I like this show. You know, years ago I did the Dinah Show, which is Dinah Shore, and it was a daytime show. And it was kind of like this. And it was just like very up and it was all positive stuff. They didn't bring negative stuff to the audience. And that's why I feel with this show. It's very relaxed. You know, it's very professional, but it's quite a bit of fun.
You can binge watch.
And binge watch.
You can binge watch.
And you can binge watch.
Binge watch, or you can binge watch.
Please binge watch.
You can binge watch.
And binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
First TV experience. I'm so happy to do it with you.
Anytime, anywhere, on EverTalk TV, your home for talk.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. Opening nationwide in theaters August 30th, we have got the stars of Bennett War in the house. Thank you so much for being with us, you guys.
Thanks for having us.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
The premiere last night. Tell us all about it.
You want to take this one away?
It was surreal. It was surreal to see, I mean, right, to walk on the Warner Brothers lot and see your name on the Warner Brothers marquee.
Right.
Like I moved to LA at 18.
Wow.
Like when, to see that was like, wow. It was pretty surreal and awesome.
When you moved to LA at 18, did you ever imagine this would be
Yeah, that's why I came here.
Exactly right.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, yes and no. Of course, you fight for it, and it's a risk. But yeah.
That.
Yeah. That's so awesome.
That's what I've been manifesting.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I've imagined it. You have too. You have to see it, right?
You have to.
You have to see it. But yeah, last night was great because there's just so many people there we love and so many people that support the film and so many people that are excited about mm-hmm. you know movies coming out like this. Mm-hmm. So it was a really fun crowd.
So what's your favorite part of the premiere?
Favorite part?
Yeah.
For me it's like a reunion, first of all. It's an opportunity mm-hmm. to finally get all your friends and family and whoever else you haven't seen in so long. But other than that, it's just it's an opportunity to celebrate a lot of hard work.
Mm-hmm. Let's and take some good pictures.
Yeah.
After this hard work, we've got the trailer for Bennett's War.
We're gonna lose the farm, son.
I'm behind on the mortgage.
The doctor said one bad fall and you could never walk again.
I'd rather risk it than die a little bit every day.
We need to secure this area ASAP.
You've been holding out on us, Bennett.
Could have gone pro, sir. What are you doing here with us?
I found out I could ride for the Rangers. I knew that's what I wanted to do.
I need you to be straight with me. What are his chances, really?
Marshall is one of the most naturally gifted riders I've ever seen.
If we're really doing this, you are crew chief, I am team manager.
Hey, Sarge.
Thank you for bringing my daddy home.
Racing is part of you.
Do what it takes.
Yes. Looks like fun. Was that fun?
Oh yeah, yeah, what a blast.
It was, so fun.
It was like three movies in one.
It was.
I'm tired looking at it. A lot of work.
What has it been like for you, this journey in Hollywood? What have you had to do? Whatever it takes.
Yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot, but I think it's always being willing to whatever's coming your way. You're always willing to face it. You're always. It's a lot of ups and downs, and that's what when I have younger actors ask me like, "What's it really like?" I'm like. This right now we're getting all kinds of love, but this isn't the norm, and that's what people have to realize. And I think that's being an artist generally, but it's always worth it, and it's been a great journey. I've really enjoyed it. I think I've really just enjoyed the process, and I think that's really part of it.
What have you learned about yourself along the way?
That there's really nothing I can't face. You know, like really, if you get your mindset right, like there's really nothing that. I don't think that I can just about face anything and face it well.
And what's your why? You know, we've had a lot of actors on it, and there's purpose-driven. There's people that just love the art of acting. What is it? What's your why? What's your purpose around this?
I love being able to tell stories that someone in the audience is going to watch it and be able to relate or feel something. And I like being able to give a voice to someone's life circumstance so that they feel like they're heard and they're not alone.
Love that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like last night we had some, personally I think you had some as well, some military vets came up afterwards. Mm-hmm. And they spoke, well, everyone had their own little story, but they spoke about how much it meant to them. Mm-hmm. A couple of them had to walk out of theater. It hit so home for them. And for me, that's what it's about.
Right.
It's like that opportunity for connection and to tell a story that can help heal and help inspire and also entertain.
But did you know that when you first started, you know, years and years ago in acting? Was it like, I want to affect somebody out there? Or was it just like the love that just it grew into that? Was it always about that?
I think for me, it was just like you find a spark, right?
Yeah.
Like I got up on a dusty stage somewhere and I started saying some lines, bumbling out of my mouth.
Yeah.
I'm like, this feels right. let's see where that goes.
My earliest memories, I was always in a costume, always on stage, always doing skits, always telling a story. I don't really remember a time when I wasn't performing for someone.
Yeah. It's amazing. Yeah. It's amazing. People just sort of
just
born
know.
With, the clarity around their purpose. Mm-hmm. I just love that. Mm-hmm. If there was one signature strength or personality quality or trait that you think has led to your success, what is that strength or quality?
There's not just one, first
one.
Of all.
Yeah.
Like the first thing that comes to mind is perseverance.
Mm-hmm.
And that's for everything in my life. It's not just being an actor. It's it's,
it doesn't it's, help I mean, hurt that you guys are drop dead gorgeous.
Right? Thank you.
So what's that like? All the attention, all the, how do you like weed through the people out there? Like, these are my peeps, this is my inner circle, versus someone just wants something from me in Hollywood?
I think it's your intuition.
Yeah.
It's definitely trusting that gut intuition when you meet someone. And I always try to be kind. That's like my number one thing, is just be kind to everyone and place no judgment. But you always have that little intuition that tells you who's there for you to ride and who's not.
Yeah, what's just your one, your boundaries.
What's your one thing for what you, why you feel like you're successful?
I think I work really hard. I think this is truly my purpose. And I just try really hard to be kind to people and be someone that they want to work with again.
Yeah.
We had the pleasure of having Ollie and Christina on the show on Monday. Of course, they're some of the producers of the Forest Films. What was that community like for you?
Oh, it's family.
Family.
Yeah. Straight almost family. Very, it can be dysfunctional at times.
What family? Otherwise, another family. Yeah.
But I mean, that's really part of it. You kind of have to, I think the dysfunction sometimes helps drive the train because it's a lot. It's a lot of pressure. It's long days, but we all ultimately enjoy being around each other.
Yeah. I met Allie in acting class 9 years ago, 9 or 10 years ago. So yeah, truly family. Yeah.
What are you each most looking forward to now?
Ooh.
Well, the premiere was last night, so I'm looking forward to sleep.
Yes, not bad, yeah. I'll probably get home at what, 2 or 3?
Well, we got, what, 2 weeks, 3 weeks until release? Mm-hmm. So I'm personally really excited to just put something good out in the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we really believe in the story, and I put a lot into it. I know Allison put a lot into it.
For sure.
And we hope people respond to it.
Yeah, congratulations, you guys.
You. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow your personal journeys as well as the film.
Yeah. I guess Instagram's a thing, right? Like whatever. So I'm Allison Page, and then N, as in Nancy.
Michael S. Rourke.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Thank you guys
so much.
Thanks, guys.
Looking at theaters nationwide. I'm not going to stay tuned. We'll be back tomorrow on Good Morning Lawline.
Where can you watch the stories of people changing the world? EverTalk TV, the Netflix of talk. I'm Jez Moyer, the co-founder and host of EverTalk TV, and I am thrilled to introduce you to America's first live video streaming talk show network.
You can binge watch.
And binge watch.
You can binge watch.
And you can binge watch.
Binge watch.
You can binge watch.
Please binge watch.
You can binge watch.
And binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Uplift and empower you anytime, anywhere on EverTalk TV, your home for talk.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land on Wealth Wednesday. One of our greatest wealth is our pets. We love animals in La La Land. Most of us have dogs other than children. There are our children. I do have a child. But so we have Happy Again Pet. Anja is in the house to help us with the pain with dogs, right? Tell us a little bit about what that is.
So Happy Again is a supplement for the joints for dogs to prevent their joint health and also help them with joint discomfort that's already there for older dogs.
Mm-hmm. We know you have a very powerful partner in this business, Cesar Millan. The dog was for himself. Let's take a look. Happy Again Pet.
I'm super happy today because we're gonna make sure that our dogs run, swim, and walk for a living the rest of their life, and hopefully they can live forever. I'm super excited to tell you that I'm partnering with Anya. This super product has made Junior actually super happy, has made him actually mobilize more, wake up normal. Junior is now 12, believe it or not. I know everybody saw Junior growing up on the TV shows, and he is now 12, and I have to make sure that his mobility, his joints, and his lifestyle, his spirit, and his heart has always been taken care of. It's all about being in tune with Mother Nature, natural, simple, profound, making sure that we gain trust, respect, and love. making sure that our dogs know that we are honest and that we have integrity and loyalty, because I want my dogs to live with a human that they actually admire. You can see thousands of bulldogs, but one means something to your heart. Yes. You know what I mean? So animal, dog, breed, name. So we want to make sure, I want to make sure that my participation to the dog life, when he's with me, he is at the happiest he can ever be. HappyAgainPet.com, ask anything you want, but first do your research. It works. You're staking it, Gio's staking it. Now the whole pack is gonna take it.
Oh, so cute. Tell us about this little guy right here.
This is Freya. She's just 1 year old, but she is a Happy Again.
She's
dog,
adorable.
I'd be happy too if I was iced up like that.
Living
a good life.
What is unique and very special to this product?
So I developed the product for my bulldog, Tony. He was an English bulldog and was skateboarding, and that was his biggest passion, and he had problems with his joints and the shoulder. So I tried to help him and couldn't find anything on the market. And my background is in biotech engineering. So I worked in cartilage tissue engineering and could put together a supplement, and that's Happy Again, and brought him back on the board in a week.
Cool, wait, he liked to skateboard. Yeah. That was his favorite thing. He just would go out and he's like, he's on the skateboard.
Do you remember
again.
Spud McKenzie? That was like a big thing.
They have that talent.
So is Happy Again something that we should give our dogs as a preventative, or only dogs that are experiencing pain?
Preventative and when they're older, for both. It is a really unique supplement. It is all natural. We don't use any artificial flavors, fillers, or additives. And it is very good for their coat, for their skin, and prevents the joints from getting older.
Wow. So how does it work? Is it anti-inflammatory? And
it's based on a hydrolyzed collagen, which is a natural substance in our body and the dog's body.
Don't we all need that?
Yeah. Collagen?
Can we take what's the difference between something for the dog versus us?
Ours is actually human grade. I take it myself.
Yeah.
You
do? That's amazing.
Happy See? Again as well. Please tell everyone where they can get Happy Again Pet.
At happyagainpet.com. That's our website, and yeah, you can purchase it there.
Okay, well, we're gonna take your dog.
Okay. Cute.
We're gonna skateboard too. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Hi, I'm Dr. Erin, host of Good Morning Lalan on EverTalk TV. I'm a doctor of divinity, and I absolutely love being a host. And the reason why is because each day I wake up and I come into the studio and I'm always blown away by the amount of different stories coming together. My mission is to awaken a billion people. And I have been blown away to realize that it's not just the spiritual people, that we talk to people that are on reality TV, we talk to actors, we talk to people who have had incredible stories and trials and triumphs, and there's a common denominator between all of them. Every single person desires to have a greater life and awaken to the best life they can live. I'm Dr. Erin, and I'm a host on EverTalk TV.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Lalan. These two ladies are a force to be reckoned with in the film community. Thank you so much for being with us, Lottie and Krista. So tell us a bit about the slate of films that you're working on right now.
Well, we just finished a movie called Tesla with Ethan Hawke and Kyle
MacLachlan. I love Ethan Hawke! Stop the show!
Yeah. Interview's over now.
Yeah, yeah, they're like, we have a movie with Ethan Hawke. We're like, greenlit.
Yeah.
And we have Angels Fallen coming out on the 23rd of August with Jerry Butler, and Rick Waugh directed it. A big, big action film with Lionsgate. And then we have Rambo, September 20th.
Wow.
So The Last Blood.
Oh.
Wow. With Stallone, right?
With Stallone,
Always a big fan of the Rambo movies. Who wasn't?
You guys are balling. What's up?
Like, we kind of are.
The secret to your success as a powerful team, a female-driven team in Hollywood?
I think we're just connected. As soon as we met, we have a huge connection. Like, we can look at each other from across the room in a meeting, and we can know exactly what's going on. Mm-hmm. We see everything. We kind of can assess everything very quickly. We just have a great connection. So that has helped us with our business, because we don't really fight. We don't really, there's no like, well, she wants to do something and I want to do something else. We sort of are always on the same page. So, don't you agree?
I do. I mean, not always, but usually.
I agree with that.
Sometimes I want to kill her, but she doesn't know it.
Yeah, but I know she wants to kill me because I can see it in the eyes.
Women make great strides in the entertainment industry. Clearly, thank you so much for your work in pioneering that. But what advice would you have to other female filmmakers or producers who are trying to navigate Hollywood?
Well, I think with all the Me Too movement and all that, which is great, and we big supporters and happy that it happened because we obviously been, you know, part of the, I wouldn't say victims, but, you know, part of the women that were, you know, uncomfortable with some situation. But I still think that, you know, the past is the past, and don't drill on it too much and just go full force, you know, to the front and forget about it. Just do the best that you can now instead of being hurt and instead of hating people for what happened and suing people and just, you know, being negative. Just go, be positive, you know, do what you can do, the best that you can do, and move on.
Yeah, there's definitely been a shift. I mean, more women are getting hired and there's equal pay, and I think it's a good thing, and I think there's it sort of balanced itself out, and I think it's gonna balance again, rebalance. But I think a lot of, you know, it's definitely more women have opportunities and they're directing big films and...
So what would you say is the mission, other than making a ton of money, what would you say is the mission with everything you're up to?
Our mission?
Yeah.
What is our mission?
I think we both came from very humble backgrounds, and you know, we've had different sorts of careers over our lives, and you know, we struggled. We weren't like born with the you know, we came from the street, so we were raised to be hustlers and to work hard and to make something happen, and I was born ambitious. I mean, I don't know where it comes from. I just have a drive and a fire that is always like burning. So you can either get in that way or you're gonna get sizzled up.
That's so fire, true. Literally.
You're my kind of girl, so yeah, hang on.
Right? Absolutely. So what have you learned like in this journey that you now know that you maybe wish you would have known when you started? Any things that you've learned along the way that you're like, man, wow, had I known this a little earlier, I may have taken a different, slightly different path here. Not that anything is wrong with the path that you took, obviously. Mm-hmm. But is there any, what have you learned in the process that you just feel is valuable for other people to know?
I think you're constantly learning. I mean, there's so many things I've learned. Like, I'll wake up and I'll be like, oh my God, confidence is everything.
Yeah.
Fake it till you make it. All right, let's do that. You know, we used to go on these hikes. When she lived near me, we would hike every night and we would have these talks. You know, we have goals, ambitions, what's our next step? And she would say, well, we can't do that. And I'm like, yes, we can, we're going to. So I think, you know, every day we're learning new things and we're learning, you know, about, I don't know, what else?
Yeah, I mean, I would add to that what I wish I would know back then, and even now, I mean, I'm still struggling with it. So coming, being a foreigner and, you know, not the most, you know, well-spoken and you know, post-PhD educated. And especially the language, but the language is a hard thing to deal with if you don't have it perfectly. I mean, I speak a few, and English is not, you know, the best of them. So I wish I just, throughout the years, would not pay attention to that too much, and because I see some people who are foreigners. We just saw Caesar, you know, with the dogs. It's like, he just goes for it. Yeah. He doesn't care about his language or the way he, you know, and it looks great. It's good. And I was, I think, one of the, you know, I would be a little bit insecure about that.
I'm a native English speaker, and I still suck. I'm working at it. I mean, it's unbelievably hard. You're right. The confidence is everything.
Confidence, yeah. You know? Yeah. Fake it till you make it. But for me, it's very hard to do because I'm disgustingly honest sometimes, yeah. So I can't fake it. Yeah.
That's good. I mean, basically, we always say we're very too aggressive, like barbarians, but we're trying to be polite and have
But you know what? We found out that our aggressiveness works much better than when we are so nice and faking it and sweet and trying to be like everybody. And it never works. It just doesn't work. We are who we are. And, you know, if you don't like it, F you.
Yeah. Don't you have to be a little
like
savage?
Like I said, these are my girls.
In Hollywood. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow you and catch your next film.
Oh, she's the social media queen. Yeah. I am.
So we have a Campbell Grubman Films Facebook page. And I have an Instagram which she appears on.
Guest appearance.
Which is like,
cameo. Not guest, I'm the star of it. Ah.
Yeah. XTA 777, I think it is. So yeah, you're the star. Yeah, she's the star of it. Sometimes.
I have Twitter. I mean,
oh, she has Twitter. Yeah, Twitter.
Yeah,
we all, you know, all, yeah. Everything. Yeah. I mean, sort of everything.
Doesn't sound like Ethan is that concerned about your Instagram.
I don't think so. Thank you, ladies, for all the work that you've
Thank
done
you.
And all the entertainment you've contributed. Stay tuned. We'll be back tomorrow. Good morning, we'll all end.
I'm Jesmyn Wayeg, host of Good Morning La La Land on EverTalk TV. As a little girl with big dreams, I couldn't stop talking. I turned that into a career at premieres, at red carpets, and even a talk show. And recently, I had my aha moment. I was hosting a live event. A woman who represented a national cancer support community gently pulled me aside from the glitz and the glam, and she thanked me for mentioning their program on my show. Because of those few words that I had spoke on air earlier that week, one of our viewers battling cancer reached out and got the financial and emotional support she so desperately needed. I'm so grateful to have experienced that moment, a moment that truly reflects how much conversation and community matters. We need more of what matters. It is my passion and purpose to create content and lead a conversation that will ignite the light in my community and empower them to live their best lives. Starting today. I'm Jesmyn Wayeg, and I'm a host on EverTalk TV.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We have Brandon Stewart in the house. He's an actor, singer, judge of Shine, and he's the content, head of content for Brandon TV. How are you, honey?
I'm excellent. We just launched Brandon TV today, so I'm
congrats.
Like,
congratulations.
Thank you. Exciting.
Thank you so much.
What's this journey been like, American Idol alum to now Brandon TV?
It's been insane. Like, so it started in music, obviously, mm-hmm. and now I'm a judge on Shine, which was a show that I created, thankfully, and I was blessed to get it off the ground. But going from music to acting and then into producing my own content, it's been a roller coaster. Mm-hmm. Like, you really never know what's going to happen and what's going to come next around the corner of the industry, but I'm always just trying to stay on my toes and stay positive.
Well, so. I think it's such an important message because here in Hollywood, we have to wear so many hats, right? Insane. Not only can you be a singer, you're an actor, you're an entrepreneur, you're a creator, you're a producer. On top of a million other
things. It's crazy, yeah, and it gets really hard. There's a lot of, you know, personalities you have to juggle, as well as a lot of, you know, things that you have to do that normal people wouldn't have to deal with at a 9-to-5, right? Mm-hmm. Sitting at a cubicle, doing whatever you may have to do at a normal job. We don't have normal jobs, though. Like, you guys are getting up early every single day. You have to deal with, you know, cameras in your face all the time. Thankfully, I can kind of jump back and forth, so I can juggle the two of those.
So tell us about Shine.
Shine is incredible. Okay, so we are the number one competition web series in America.
Wow.
And we got that after the first season. We've rallied a bunch of attention. It's basically a singer-songwriter competition show, and we find the next underground independent artist who's not signed to a record label to help launch their career.
Oh, I love that. Let's take a look at the trailer, if we can, for Shine.
No matter the strikeouts.
You huddle.
You get knocked down.
You get up.
And seek opportunity. For that is competition. Chasing your dream. There will be hundreds of faces.
But only one can win.
Awesome. Wow.
So I do have to say that was an old thing that we had showed for the actual auditions that we had in July. But our premiere is tonight at 5 p.m. our time, 8 p.m. Wow. Eastern Standard
Congratulations.
Time. Congratulations. So, yeah. Thank you so much.
What do we have to look forward to?
A lot of crazy drama and a lot of crazy excitement. We had incredible auditions. We had over hundreds and hundreds of people that auditioned online and auditioned in person. Tonight, there's a couple of singers that you're going to see that are really talented, and there's a couple of singers that you're going to see that are a little whack-a-doodle-doo, but we had to put them on there, right?
So it's fun.
We got a few of those on here, right?
Yes, exactly.
So what is it that you look for? Obviously, you're looking for raw talent, but what else do you look for besides that?
It's so interesting. So when I was on American Idol, for me, I was 17, and so it was hard for me to really ground myself in who I was at 17, right? And we have a lot of young singers that come on the show, so we really look for that raw potential and that raw inspiration in what they do. And for me, our team is the one that are supposed to put the inspiration in you, put the potential in you, but if you already have that, then we can immediately start getting your music on Spotify, getting your music on Pandora. And what a lot of these singers don't understand is the way that the streaming digital world works, and that's what we know best now that we're partnered with Viacom. Mm-hmm. And it's insanity. It's insanity with all these singers because they come and they've got all these, you know, lyrics written or they have all these beats that are produced, but they don't know how to pair it all together, and that's mm-hmm. kind of our job. Oh. One of our judges, Ashton Jones, she's a Grammy winner, and she's incredible with, you know, really getting down to earth with these singers and telling them, you know, it takes this and this and this, because she won her Grammy as an independent artist. Wow. And it takes this and this and this to get there. People like Chance the Rapper are doing it. Lana Del Rey's been doing it for a long, long time. So there's successors out there that we're kind of looking up to and showing them that this can also be you. But it takes, you know, one step at a time.
What does that mean? That means they don't have, like, they're not under a record label if they're
yes,
independent?
Okay, exactly. Yeah. So people like, you see Gaga and Beyonce, they've got millions of people that are marketing their music, mm-hmm. right? And with today on social media, you can actually use social media as your record label. And that's what we're teaching these singers. You actually make more money that way as well. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Gaga is making plenty of money, right?
Yeah.
They make plenty of money on tour, right?
Right.
There's plenty of those singers, though, that are signed to Capitol Records, that are signed to, you know, Warner Brothers, whoever it may be, Warner Music, that are not making as much money, and they're more on the bottom of the barrel. They have to open for the big singers.
You've learned an incredible amount in a very short time, Britton. Is there something you wish you would have known before you started this journey in Hollywood?
Wow. That's a great question. Yes, there's so much. I wish that I could speak to, like, 17-year-old Brandon and then win American Idol. No, I'm kidding. I feel that it's always just one step at a time, and it's always just kind of learning as you go. For me, it's always the people that I surround myself with. I take bits and pieces of information from everybody. I'm learning how to, you know, dress from you. I'm learning how to, you know, speak from you guys. I'm learning a lot of different things as I'm growing, and every single time that I'm stepping into a room with people that are content creators, that are leaders, I'm learning from them. So it's just nuggets of information that I'm taking and sharing along
the
way.
But don't you feel like you can't really almost teach that? It's like you have to just keep going, and
you
in that
to.
Process
Absolutely.
Where all the lessons are.
Absolutely. It's the experience, I think, mm-hmm. it's the most part. And that's what we do on Shine, is we give them the experience and the platform to kind of show their best. So
amazing.
Wow. Please tell everyone again where they can watch Shine tonight.
Yes, it's on Branded TV. We just launched. It's a partnered digital company with Viacom and Awesomeness TV. And you can, which camera am I looking at?
This yes.
Okay.
Perfect.
And it's Branded TV, partnered with Viacom and Awesomeness TV. You can watch it tonight, 5 p.m. LA time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can watch it all over Branded TV. Just Google Branded TV, you'll find it.
I love
it.
Where can they find and follow your personal journey?
That's Branham Stew, B-R-A-N-M-S-T-E-W. First four letters of my first name, middle initial, first four letters of my last name.
Nice. Thank you so much. Keep shining. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more Good Morning La La Land. It is hashtag National Sour Candy Day. We want to thank our special friends from Pucker Powder for treating us today.
Hey, I mean, what is this?
What is that?
I don't know. It's like a.
Leave it to the DIY expert.
It's a sugar hookah. This looks like what I would fill up my car with, the tires. You know, so, the air thing.
For those of you watching, if you haven't met Tanya Mimi, she is an Emmy nominated host.
Oh my God, you're so
South House, Homer Colvin family. She's a DIY expert and she's always up for a challenge. So right, why not give her this sour? Here we go, Tanya.
Oh, come on.
Shut up. Woo! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
Wow! Hold on!
She's up for it! Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We're so excited to welcome filmmaker and activist Nathan Sutieri to the show. Good morning, Nathan. Thanks for being with us.
Love you being here.
You have an incredible mission. I'd like to start right at the beginning, though. What was your journey like to Hollywood, and what put this mission on your heart?
I guess I was abused as a child, and it went on for quite a while. After that, he kind of abandoned me, and then I, as a result, I, you know, found drugs and violence and fell into a dark place and doing acting in Australia, got invited to come over here and do some acting here, came here, went to New York. I was living in New York for a while. Thought I could move to New York and get away from Australia and kind of start over, but you know what New York's like, you just kind of fall straight back into it. Fell into it, hit rock bottom, came out the other side, and I guess that's when I started therapy and group therapy, went to AA, Narcotics Anonymous and Sex Anonymous, and, you know, realized what happened to me, and I learned about my journey, and you know, I truly believe what happened to me happened for a reason, and the reason why it happened to me now is to tell my story. It's to educate the world, help people, and just kind of, have the conversation. It's a worldwide thing, and
so I don't want to pull up too much of still trauma or anything, but was it a father or a friend?
I grew up in a small town in Australia, and it was just, I was at the local swimming pool summer, and he kind of followed me into the change rooms, and that's where it started. It wasn't a family friend or it wasn't a family member or anything. But yeah, you know, small town, everyone kind of knows everyone, and that's where it started.
So sorry that happened.
Every 2.5 minutes, an American experiences some sort of sexual abuse or trauma.
Absolutely.
And it's a conversation that needs to be had. It needs to be had very publicly to remove any kind of stigma or judgment or shame. So for somebody who's experienced this trauma, you know, what advice could you share with them? Where can they begin the healing process?
I think one of the first things I learned through therapy, my therapist said to me, Nathan, if you can go back and speak to your 8-year-old self, what would you tell him? And I would and I didn't really know. And then it kind of hit me, and it was, you know, it wasn't your fault. So if I can tell anyone out there who's been through this and who has the shame and who doesn't know how to talk about it, who doesn't know what to say and who to go to, just realize that it wasn't your fault. You do have the support. You do have people out there who do love you. There are avenues you can go down to get the help you need that I didn't do. And I went the other way and went into a dark place. So I think the most important thing is to realize it wasn't your fault. And I think the most important thing now is for parents and for people to educate children, is to let them know that, again, it's not their fault. They can say it. They're not going to get in trouble. You know, so I think that's the most important thing, is realizing that it's not your fault. And just knowing that there are people you can talk to, there are people you can go to who are going to help. And
so how have you taken this mission into your work you're doing now?
Well, I, you know, was acting, and I've written a script about my life. I was a keynote speaker at the 7th Annual Child Abuse Conference in Wisconsin. So I've written this script, and for me, it's just about, like I said, it's about educating people, getting the story out there. And it's, you know, it's very raw, it's very dark, it's very real. Because that's what it is.
Right.
You know, I didn't write it to sugarcoat it for Hollywood, or, you know, if I offend some people, so be it, because that is real life. Right. You know, it's not an easy life. It's not a simple...
You said when the incident happened and then you were speaking about him, and then you said, and then he abandoned me. What did you mean by that?
He just kind of disappeared. He just kind of disappeared out of my life, because I guess I had that Stockholm syndrome where you feel feelings for your abuser and you feel love for him through the grooming and through the manipulation and the lies, and your parents hate you. They're not going to believe you. Anything you say, you're going to get in trouble. You're going to go to jail and all that type stuff. So through that, and at this conference, I spoke to a survivor, and he said to me, he goes, do you know why this guy abandoned you? Why he left you and just kind of, and I'm like, I don't know. Did he get in trouble? Did he get caught? Did something happen? And he goes, no, he said, because you were growing up. You were turning into a man. You were getting hair on your body. You weren't this little boy anymore. Mm-hmm. And it kind of just hit me, and I was like, wow, yeah, that makes so much sense.
Wow. So it was ongoing.
It was an ongoing. It went on from 8 through to about 12, 13.
Wow.
I'm so inspired by your transparency, your courage, your bravery. I mean, it's really, it's just inspiring. And, you know, I wonder, you know, you sought out a lot of professional support groups, therapies, and therapists. Out of all that, what do you find, or what did you find, that was most helpful?
Good question. Talking about it.
Yeah,
getting it out.
Yeah.
And it's kind of funny, because, you know, my parents and my family never knew. I kept it a secret for 25 years. And it was always easier to talk to strangers about it, because I know I'm going to talk to you about it, and then I'm going to go, and I'm never going to see you again. So it was always easier in that regard. So that's why therapy was such a good thing. Therapy saved my life, because I could just go and sit and talk about it and let it all out. And that's kind of where the script came from, evolved, because my therapist I wasn't able to talk about it. So he would always say, just write it down. Go home, write this stuff down. Come back next week and we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
So I had all these pages and all these paragraphs of what I did and what I went through and where I was, and spoke to some, you know, very good friends of mine and my therapist, and they're like, Nathan, you have an amazing story here. Mm. You need to tell this story. You need to get it out there. And, mm. you know, I had this article come out. I'm not sure if you guys have read it. I had an article come out in this Australian newspaper. And after it came out, I've had over 200 people reach out to me on Instagram and Facebook and through email saying, you've saved my life. You've given me the courage to tell my story. You've allowed me to talk to my parents, my brothers and sisters, whoever and whatever the situation is. So I know that was just through an article in Australia. So, you know, the reach that this film could have and the effect it could have on the world. And it is a worldwide thing. It is still such a taboo thing. And you know, we need to have the conversation. Right. And it is difficult, but, you know, we need to start somewhere.
Thank you for being so transparent, really, truly. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow you and reach out to you for support.
I guess my Instagram, yeah, Nathan Spiteri. I have a website, nathanspiteri.com, where I've got people who are unable to tell their story and who have no one to talk to. They can write into my website and just write their story down mm-hmm. and share it that way.
So important.
So I've had a lot of people start doing that as well. So, yeah, just Nathan Spiteri, I guess.
I love that. Yeah, I think it's so important because we hear about the women all the time, but we rarely hear about the men.
We rarely hear about the
men. So thank you so much for being that voice for helping others. So thank
Absolutely.
You very much.
Absolutely.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Oh,
10
seconds left.
What's up?
Oh. 10 seconds left.
That was the curveball. That was the curveball. Unintentional curveball.
That was the rush. You scared me. I was like, okay.
3, 2, 1.
Oh. Wow.
Good design.
Okay.
Now, show the camera.
Up to you to choose the winner. Is it Annie? Is it Haley?
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Law. And we have a brother and sister duo in the house, Jocelyn and Chris. You guys are amazing. You're going to like rock
Thank
it
you.
Tonight, right?
Yeah.
Big show in the hood?
Yeah, we're playing the standard tonight. We're playing a special semi-acoustic set, so we're going to strip some stuff down.
That's iconic, iconic yeah. place in Hollywood.
I'm so excited.
Right?
I've never been. So.
Topping the Billboard charts, today's show praised you as like some of the best millennial take on classic rock. Where did this journey begin for you?
Yeah, it all started, so both of our parents are teachers, neither of them are musicians, but they've always loved music, so they have this massive music collection, and we basically just listened to everything we could growing up. A lot of classic rock, a lot of jazz, a lot of blues.
A lot of jamming in the living room.
Yeah.
Mom being like, turn it down! That.
We've got a little video here, what are we seeing?
Oh yeah,
Ooh.
This is the music video for our song, Out of My Head. Yeah.
What was the inspiration for the song, Out of My Head? Because sometimes I feel that way. Like this morning, it was a little out of my head.
Yeah, so I guess it's like we all have that thing or that person or that idea that sticks in there and it's really hard to get out. And that's kind of, the song is our attempt to get that out of our heads through writing a song about it. So.
I love that. You should have a friend who would say, I lost my mind a long time ago and I still don't miss it.
So you guys grew up in the living room. Here you are, like, doing whatever. When did it get real? You're like, we actually got something here.
We were playing the beer tent at a local fair mm-hmm. when we met our current producer.
A beer tent at a fair.
And it's funny because we were in high school, so it's not like we could drink the beer. But it was like four people, including my parents, and then David Bourgeois, who ended up being like, you know, you could do this for a living, right? And we're like, what? That's way too cool to be a job. But then from there, 6 years, fast forward, we're here.
Fast forward, sibling superpower too. What would you say is her superpower? What would you say is his?
Ooh. She sleeps in a lot. She's really no, I would sleep. Yeah. As a musician, as somebody to work with, I mean, we've always just been super close. She's been my best friend for my whole life, Aww. So I would not want to write songs with anyone else. And then you guys should go listen to her sing because she's got in one of the most powerful voices I've heard, I think.
Wow. I'd say for him, beyond being like an insane shredder on the guitar, he is also super patient with me, like when I'm not waking up in the morning or, yeah, that's your superpower, super patience.
Oh.
Super patience.
Yeah.
In that 6 years between sort of when you met the producer and now, yeah. What would you say were the highlights of that period of time? Like, were there certain things that happened that you were just like, man, this is so validating and I just know this is heading in the right direction?
The Today Show was a big one.
That was
yeah, that announced for sure.
Having Al Roker come up and being like, yeah, that was a cool song. Wow. I put that on my gravestone, like I'm done. Yeah. But also we got to play Mountain Jam, the main stage, and you know, they start rolling in like Blood the Black Keys gear and Robert Plant's gear.
Yeah,
and
that was amazing.
Oh my God, this is very real,
wow.
Hitting me. Yeah.
Are there any artists or acts that you would love to play with? I mean, who's on the bucket list?
Oh.
Let's manifest this right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, totally. The one that I've been listening to lately, I think, is Hozier.
Oh,
I just love him, and he's just so, so good. But I mean, really, anyone that has good music, I would love to play with.
The Rolling Stones.
Yeah, that would be great.
Yeah, I feel like that's like, right? You know, you made it.
Yeah. So what's the ideal scene? You're traveling around the globe, doing whatever. Like, what's the ideal scene?
Doing this for a living.
Yeah.
It's. I mean, it seems crazy that we get to do it right now. So we're just going to keep pushing, keep climbing, and just keep trying to make music our life, because it already is. So
mm-hmm. You've got a great show at the Standard tonight. And then what's next for you?
We are on tour, so we're headed out to, where are we going next? Like Sacramento, Idaho, like all the way up almost to Canada.
Yeah.
So back down.
Have you gone on any places on this tour that kind of surprised you or that you really liked?
Absolutely. So the Midwest, we always drive through. But we actually stopped there this time and we played some shows and it was awesome.
I'm from the Midwest. It
was so cool. The people there are so nice and they all love music.
The middle of Nebraska gets lit on like a Tuesday.
It was so cool.
Turn it up on a Tuesday.
Yeah, exactly.
That's so funny. So is it hard though? I mean, the road life is not easy at all.
It's definitely hard. I mean,
it's a grind.
But it's a good thing we love it.
Yeah, it's a
lovable
grind.
Otherwise it would be very hard.
Yeah.
What's the hardest part of your life right now?
The schedule,
yeah. Right?
You guys were talking about that earlier, like explaining our job schedule to people who have a normal job. You guys can really, like, I'm like tuned in to be my most awake at like 10:30 p.m. So,
I'm tuned in to be the most sleep.
Right. I'm not even awake right now.
I'm like, so let's talk real quick about Killing the Cure.
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, so Killing the Cure, it's our current radio single, and it's climbing the AAA Billboard charts right now. I think it's at number 29 right now and going up, so.
It was awesome. And the week we added it to, the week it was like Impact Radio Day. Mm-hmm. It was the most added song in AAA radio in the country.
Wow.
So we were really, really excited
about
that.
We're like,
congratulations, you guys.
Thank you.
Please tell everyone where they can find and follow your personal journeys and of course your music.
Yeah, so you Google Jocelyn and Chris and we should come up. We're also on Instagram at Jocelyn and Chris Music. Kind of our shared page.
So rad. So great to see a brother and sister get along and make great music together. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
It was a great show tonight.
Thank you.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Lalan on Wealth Wednesday. We're here to talk about a little bit of cashola also. So we have Chris Noggle in the house. He is the money multiplier. You may have seen him on HGTV, Risky Builders, correct?
Got it.
Right? And then we have the Real Estate Money School podcast.
Yeah.
Wow. We don't need anything else. We got enough cash now.
Just talking money. Multiply my money. Who doesn't?
Do it.
Right?
Let's do it.
So how do we do that?
How do you multiply your money? Well, it's actually so simple, and it's a 200-year-old strategy. It's been around forever. It's been right under your nose. You just never even knew it was there. The Rockefellers created it. Yeah, so for example, I talk all over the country on stages, and I teach people how to get all the money back for all the cars they're ever going to buy, drive, and own. That's like a good thing. Everybody's just like, well, I'm used to just wasting money on cars, so how do I get it all back? So we do that. We show people how to erase debt, and it's simple. It's just recapturing and recycling all the money you're paying to everybody else. I mean, think about it. How much money every month you spend on other people and on other institutions. You pay your credit card, you pay all your bills. What if you could get all that money back?
Rob's kicking me under the table, literally.
I am.
Because we've been talking about cars, and so the universe sent us to you to us. So how do they do? They listen to your podcast, they watch your show, they get all these gems.
Yeah, and also we have a webinar that we put out, and it's moneyschoolrei.com/TMM. Mm-hmm. And that teaches people how to do it. And then from there, we just help them set up the banking system. It's really simple.
Wow.
I know, I came 17 years as a high-level financial advisor doing all the Wall Street stuff, and I retired last year because of the HGTV show. Uh-huh. And all of a sudden, I took the rosy-colored glasses off, and I'm like, wait a second, this was all a big lie. So let's tell the truth. Let's teach people how money really works instead of the big lie.
It is. So, I mean, when you really understand how criminal it is of even just the amount of you know, devaluation of the dollar, I get a little mad. I'm not going to lie. Like, I'm thinking it's like right. It's like taking the crime of all the people who have worked so hard for their money. It's really sad. They really need to get educated. So I really want to thank you for all your work of helping people.
Absolutely. It's my pleasure.
That, right? So how do they work with you?
They can just get a hold of me. I mean, I'm all over Instagram, all over social media, and they can find me anywhere there or just come see me speak.
Yeah. So do you believe in real estate as the best investment?
Oh, of course. We have a large real estate company. Mm-hmm. So real estate's always the end goal, but first we need to take care of the beginning goals to get people there.
I love that.
Where can people even start with that? Because I would love to be an investor in real estate. Okay. I'd love to even own my own home. Where can somebody even get their finances right to have a conversation like that?
It's a good question, and I've got my book, The Private Money Guide, which teaches people where all the money is for all the deals they're ever going to do, and it's right there. Money is everywhere. It's very easy to get. You just need to know how to present an opportunity to solve people's problems. And I think we all have the same problem, and that is, we want to make more money, right? Isn't that a common problem?
Sure.
So if you can solve that problem for people, you can find money, and that's all we do. We teach people how to solve that problem, and that problem is solved by real estate. So if you've got an opportunity, present that opportunity to somebody with money and show them how they can have a secured investment with your real estate deal, and they'll lend the money. So. Hmm.
We've got some very wealthy guests, and I feel like I should be checking these couch cushions right now.
Yeah. There might be some money.
Maybe yours.
Money.
Maybe yours.
So what about the downturn? Because, I mean, I'm a true believer in real estate, and I believe that, you know, buy and hold is always a great thing, no matter what market, you can always see it through. But what about that? What do you tell people that are like, oh, real estate's terrible because it's going to downturn and you'll lose everything and all that?
I'm so happy you answered that or asked that question, because that is the core question. What happens when it all goes down again, right? And it is going to.
Sure.
Wall Street's probably going to take a dump in the 6 to 8 month time frame. Probably shouldn't say that on this, but whatever I just did. When that goes down, it's going to create massive opportunities in real estate. The market's too high. I'm not even buying real estate right now, and I'm openly saying that, like, because I don't want to buy high. Warren Buffett says, buy low, sell high, right? That's what he says. And he says, don't lose money. So how do you not lose money? Well, get out right now and wait for that opportunity. That's all you got to do is just wait for the market to go down and then start buying.
Totally,
it's like
love what
you're doing. Piece of candy. That's all it is. Mm-hmm. Just pick it up.
I love it. Thank you so much. So tell people where they can work with you, follow you.
Yeah, the best way to find me and to work with me is Instagram. It's Chris_Naugle, N-A-U-G-L-E. Or go to our link, moneyschoolrei.com/TMMM.
Awesome. Fantastic. Love it.
Thank you so very
much. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
We won't be right back.
We won't.
We're going to stay right here, apparently.
Yeah. Okay. So it's hashtag Wealth Wednesday. And Chris, I want to know from you, we know you're a money man, but what do you think true wealth really is?
True wealth is just the freedom and the happiness that you get out of life. It doesn't matter. Money can't buy happiness. Wealth is really having a healthy family, you know, having your own health, enjoying your life, having the freedom to do what you want when you want to do it. That's true wealth to me. It's not how much money you have in the bank. And matter of fact, if you got a bunch of money sitting in the bank, you're doing it all wrong, because your money's got to be in motion. All we're taught to do in life is give up our good dollars today and be paid back with weaker dollars later, right? So why are we giving up our good dollars, the dollars that can change our life today? Mm-hmm. Keep those, keep control of your money, and enjoy your life.
Love that.
So well said.
I'm
Thank
in.
You so much.
Sign me up.
And America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday to Friday at 9 a.m. All of today's interviews are available as a podcast on iTunes, and the whole show is streaming on EverTalk TV on Apple TV and Roku.
That's right. We're waking up the world together $1 at a time. No, it's an amazing day, you guys. True wealth in all areas through love and our community. Have a great day.
It's going to be a good morning, La La Land.
Awesome, brother. I appreciate it.
Okay, I need to talk to them. I'm about to buy a car, and I couldn't get a loan for all my money in my business.
Okay.
But I feel like it's like the universe is like, just wait. There's something going to happen.
Seriously.
I need your help.
I can easily play out and do that. I can show you how to do it, whether it's a Ford Focus or a Ferrari. It doesn't matter.
When you hear how it works. Well, you said real estate forever, and I have a lot of investments. In 2018, long level. I have investments in real estate in Arizona.
I'll say something. I lost it all in 08. 08, 09.